Hello, my name is Weibin Chen. I'm the Director of the Scientific Operation with the Pharmaceutical Business Operation for Waters Corporation. Today, what I'm going to do to talk to you about some of the wholesale protein analysis work that we recently accomplished using LC-HDMS-2E. So basically, this work is the continuation of the work we have been doing for wholesale protein analysis by LCMS for a number of years. The recent example that I presented here are actually coming off a 3 independent laboratory study based on the methodology of LCMS2E using one simpose. So let me walk you through the poster. First, I will talk about a little bit about the methodology, what's presented in the poster, and then talk about some of the results that are obtained from the laboratories in these particular samples. First of all, I'm assuming some of you know the background about wholesale protein analysis, why it's important. So let me just briefly introduce this based on some of the regulatory understanding and some of the background information. So wholesale protein generally are the protein produced when biopharma industry producing the drug target, because the drug target are expressed by the host cells. So now those proteins tend to be foreign to the human body, therefore can be problematic, such as immunogenic reaction or the drug stability. As a result of that, the regulatory have a specifically guideline telling the industry wholesale protein need to be strictly monitored and be detected. So one of the common assays for wholesale protein is something called the ELISA assay. There are the industry sort of a standard at this point of time, and a lot of people using these for wholesale protein analysis. There are some challenges with that assay. One of the bigger challenges when people do wholesale protein analysis with the ELISA, the result tend to be just a single number. So you have no idea about what's in the wholesale protein in terms of the name, in terms of the individual concentration of each wholesale protein. As a result of that, people are starting looking at the wholesale protein analysis using so-called orthogonal method. That's what this poster is about. So we develop an orthogonal LCMS method for wholesale protein analysis. There are some challenges for wholesale protein analysis when LCMS methodologies apply to wholesale protein analysis. That is, the bigger dynamic range, protein very complex, and therefore you need a sensitivity instrument. Also, you need a high resolution separation in order to identify the low abundance wholesale protein. One of the things for wholesale protein in a purified therapeutic drug is the concentration of a wholesale protein tend to be very, very low. People use the term here talks about PPM, that's parts per million in the mass sense. Another way to look at it, that's called one PPM means 1 nanogram per milligram of a sample. So we come up with a couple different strategies to cope with the complexity of a wholesale protein sample and the low concentration of a wholesale protein in order to be identified and quantified. The first thing is we're using a 2-dimensional chromatography, which is implemented by our product called QEDM class. So in which we have a setup that can automatically do 2-dimensional chromatography separation. So when the protein or the wholesale protein samples are digest, load onto the sample, so we do a 2-dimensional separation. The first dimension is called fractionation. Typically, you can decide, depending on the sample complexity, how many fractions you wanted to do in the first dimension. So in this particular example, we do 10-step fraction. Now, those programmed steps can be implemented easily by the system that the M class. Right, that's the first thing. Now, this first diagram or figure that talks a little bit about the 2-dimensional chromatography schematic, that is, okay, what's used in the first dimension, how the first dimension separation is automatically diluted into the second dimension, and how the sample from the second dimension get to be resolved in a high resolution CSH column. This second figure talks about the reproducibility of performance of the separation for this particular chromatography setup. So that will show you two examples to demonstrate some of the reproducibility aspect of the M class. Another technique we use in terms of analyzing whole cell protein, because I mentioned the complexity of the sample, that is just with the two-dimensional chromatography itself may not be adequate enough to give you the sensitivity you would need for whole cell protein analysis, that is to go to a single digit ppm level of whole cell protein. So the second technique we include in this poster or in this methodology which is presented in the poster, that is ion mobility separation. Because ion mobility separation is done in the microsecond scale versus of the second scale or minutes of the typical LC level of separation. So we incorporate ion mobility into the methodology. So in the top of a LC separation, we also do the ion mobility separation. So why do you want to do that? The benefit of that, which is greatly simplify the spectra that allow us to clearly see the low abundance of whole cell protein signal, which is showing in the figure 3, where we compare the same retention time window of the chromatogram or of the mass spectra with and without mobility separation. The top one is without mobility separation, and the bottom one is with mobility separation. You can clearly see we remove a lot of interference species surrounding the whole cell protein peak, which is highlighted by the blue arrow. So in this way, we can be a lot more targeted focus to get easier to identify the whole cell proteins. Okay, continuing on the next portion of this poster, we talk about the result that we did with the three different independent lab and for a common sample. In a way, we try to use this type of experimental design to demonstrate the reproducibility or the robustness of this particular assay. So here we list the table that lists all the whole cell protein in this particular sample that were discovered by three different labs. So this is the number of whole cell proteins, the identity, as well as each individual whole cell, the concentration of each individual whole cell protein is listed in this table. Now we also highlight the whole cell protein which is in yellow. Those are the ones that actually only be found when the ion mobility is turned on. So they have a two bullet point that it begs you to say, for the ones that are not highlighted, those are the ones that have been discovered or they've been identified when ion mobility were not applied. So you can quickly calculate the number you will see with ion mobility applied to it. In addition to the one we found without ion mobility, we find a 4 times more of a whole cell protein, where most of the whole cell protein are in a low concentration. So with this experimental result, we saw the demonstrate that we can confidently identify whole cell protein down to a single digit ppm, which one typically people wanted to do for some of the higher purity samples. We also list some of the results because the work we demonstrated here is very high sensitivity identification of whole cell protein in a complex sample. You need to have some sort of a proof to convince people the result is solid, is robust. So that's the additional piece of information presented in the remainder of the poster. That is, we provide concrete evidence for the confirmation of these of this whole cell protein that have been identified in this process. So those figure 6 give the two high quality spectra, the MS-MS spectra that this experiment produced in terms of confirming the spectra, confirming the whole cell protein identification. Now this table 2 list, we provide all the peptide that has been identify, has been used to identify the whole cell protein. We provide additional evidence for people who are interested to analyze this sample, look at the sample again. So this is another piece of information to validate the assay. So in conclusion, this poster presents you the recent development from Waters for the whole cell protein analysis using LC HDMS to the E. So the success of this assay contribute the three main factors. One, we're using two-dimensional chromatography. Secondly, we're using the ion mobility incorporated. And the thirdly, basically, of the one of the chemistry column, I have not particularly pointed out, which is the CSH column. So, as I said earlier, the ICs become clearly demonstrated using this NIST sample, which is a common reference sample that coming from NIST. And also we compare the difference with and without mobility to clearly identify the role of mobility in host cell protein analysis. For more information about the host cell protein analysis, please visit waters.com. Thank you for your attention.